Hey everyone, it's Pixelate here and welcome back to the channel. It's been a minute since I've uploaded a video because there has not really been any news since the release of The Sims 4 Eco Lifestyle. We've had a few patches and emergency hotfix updates here and there, but that's been pretty much it. So I just woke up, I've been sitting here playing my train simulator game, and I get a tweet notification from Sim Guru Connor. He tweets, "Today at 1 PM, which was exactly a minute and a half ago, my final nifty knitting blog is up. Go check it out. Let's talk about knitting." And he shares a gif of a sim knitting and the cats playing with a basket of yarn. You guys, I'm excited. So we already know that there's pack integration with this one. Of course, if you have the Sims 4 Cats and Dogs expansion pack and the Sims 4 Nifty Knitting Stuff Pack, which is coming sometime in the future, then you get this gameplay that you see in the GIF. So let's head over to the blog post. Welcome back to our latest and last deep dive into the gameplay of the Sims 4 Nifty Knitting Stuff Pack. I've really enjoyed sharing the designs and development of this pack with you, and I hope to continue doing these sorts of posts in the future. It's been a super cool experience, and I hope you've enjoyed reading these. In today's post, I'll talk about the feature that is core to everything in this pack, knitting. Once again, I have to remind you that we're still in active development on the pack, and so some things may change between now and the final game. Now, let's talk about some nifty knits. In order to start knitting, you need to purchase a yarn basket from Build by Catalog. You probably remember voting on these baskets a while back. This was the winning design presented to you now in all its colorful glory. Don't like color? That's okay, because we included a solid black and white variant. You guys, I'm so excited for this. I guess this is what the cats were playing with on the first GIF. We have one more knitting basket coming too. Remember this one? The basket acts as a crafting catalyst. Neat term, huh? Similar to the easel or woodworking bench in The Sims 4 base game. But unlike those examples, the yarn basket is meant to live in a Sims inventory so that they can take their knitting anywhere they want to. Knitting itself is relatively straightforward. Click on the yarn basket in your inventory, or with the basket in your inventory, click on the chair you want to sit in while knitting, perhaps a rocking chair, and select the knit interaction. Oh, that's sweet. Your projects are saved to your sim, so you can pause your progress at any time and resume later, and even juggling multiple projects at once. Starting a project costs a small amount of simoleons for the cost of yarn, but nothing too outrageous, and that's expected, that's normal. Children can knit too. As a sim levels up in their knitting skill, they'll have access to new patterns. They'll start with knitting socks and beanies, but as they grow more skilled, they can tackle more challenging projects like sweaters and toys for kids. But if you only want to specialize in one thing, perhaps knitted mailbox cozies, that's fine too. Just keep knitting anything and everything, and you'll be level 10 before you know it. Speaking of knitting, sometimes your skill is reflected in your knitting work, or rather your lack of skill. Knitting projects can fail, and when they fail, they can get weird, but it's all subjective, and maybe you'll end up accidentally knitting the cutest derpy companion or the perfectly itchy sweater. No mistakes, only happy accidents. Just own it. One of the niftiest parts of the knitting skill is unlocking the ability to teach to knit, where Sims sit down together and have a knitting powwow. We wanted this to feel special, so we got a really sweet animation for it. Now that you can infect other Sims with the knitting bug, no yarn ball will be safe. The knitting needles aren't finished on the teach to knit interaction yet, but trust me, it's super cute. I can already see it now. The parents already gonna teach like the kid how to thread the needle and stick it through the hole in the needle. That's gonna be so cute. So what can you do with all these knitting projects? Lots of stuff. Not only can knitted objects be listed on Popsy, but you can also donate them to charity. If you want to surprise a loved one, try gifting a knitted object too. If you want to destroy all traces of your knitted failures, you can frog the object and start again. If it's a particularly nice sweater that you made, consider adding it to wardrobe to make it available and create a sim to all. family members. Everyone appreciates a nice gift. We want Sims to be able to knit something for their whole family. Not only will Sims be able to knit toddler onesies, but baby onesies as well. So put your little grub worm in a handmade knitted outfit. I'm sure they'd thank us if they could. And if they didn't like it, I'm sure they'd be polite about it. You guys, we can knit stuff for the babies. Actual babies. Yay! Here's a sneak peek at some of the concept art for new clothing for the littlest of Sims. It also felt like a good idea to add an aspiration to tie this passion for knitting all together. So if you want to master the fuzzy art of knitting, consider signing your Sim up for the Lord or Lady of the Knits aspiration. With yarn running through your veins, there will be no knitting mountain too hard to conquer. Master the aspiration, you'll be rewarded with the sacred knitting knowledge trait. What does it do? Lots of stuff. What does it unlock? Something special. Am I being vague? I am. Come on, guys, I can't share all the secrets quite yet. As I've mentioned previously, we're trying to get as much cross-pack functionality for knitting as we can. Cats can play with yarn baskets and yarn balls. There will be new club rules for knitting, new class electives at university, and knitting counts for emotional control, just to name a few. I'm happy knitting feels nice and snug alongside our other gameplay systems. Now let's have a chat with our lead object modeler, Beth. Connor, can you tell us a little bit about what an object modeler does on The Sims 4, Beth? As an object modeler, I spend a lot of time trying to figure out how to make objects work in The Sims 4. This is actually a very involved process and somewhat different from the wonderful work our environment team does. We work with designers, concept artists, engineers, animators, VFX artists, basically everyone, to make sure that Sims can use an object properly in an animation or that all of our objects will work with each other. Once we understand the design for a new object, we will create a rig, a block model, a very generic version of the object used to help us make more of the same object in the future, and a footprint tells us where the objects can go and how Sims move around it. Once those are tested by animators and other disciplines, we can model the final version, create UVs, and add textures. We also hook up and test everything in the game to make sure it all looks good. There is a lot to think about when it comes to making objects because we know players can find so many interesting ways to place and use them in game. This makes it a very fun challenge to make them work with everything else we've built before. Connor, what feature are you most excited to work on in Nifty Knitting Stuff? Beth, I'd say I'm most excited to work on the rocking chairs. I love that we are bringing them into the game and can't wait to see them in some cozy living rooms or on porches. Connor, what are some of the challenges you are facing working on this pack? Beth, one of the biggest challenges is ensuring that the knitting itself looks good and is fun to watch. This is a challenge given that it needs to work for everything you can create. Figuring this out takes a lot of iteration between modeling, animation, engineering, design, and art direction so that we can come to a conclusion that will work the best given our time and technical constraints. Another interesting challenge is the fact that I crochet as a hobby myself. When you are knowledgeable about something, yarn in real life, working on it in game, it can sometimes be hard to separate the things you know and may expect in reality from what is possible or best within a video game. I have to make sure to keep a balance and to conceptualize how we can best convert the knitting experience into The Sims 4. As someone who also generally enjoys interior design and architecture, this is actually one of my favorite challenges and one of the things I love about working on objects in The Sims 4. Sorry, I just cracked one of my knuckles. Connor, what is your favorite feature you have ever worked on in The Sims 4? Beth, I think it has to be a tie between the mini fridge or the robotics table in Discover University. That pack was the first time I really got to take an entire feature from start to finish. I've been with Maxis for a while, but I'm relatively new to The Sims 4. Both of these objects had some complex features we wanted that required a lot of iteration. I learned a ton about the technical aspect of our game during the process as well. I've also worked on a very few cool things between then and now, but those can't be shared yet. As a fan of The Sims since the very beginning, I am so happy to be able to share a little about what I do on a daily basis on The Sims 4 with you. I haven't been on The Sims 4 for quite quite as long overall, but some of you may also recognize me from my time on Sims Mobile, where I shared some of our workflows on Twitter for making a juice bar. Thanks, Connor. You shared a screenshot of the in-progress rocking chair in our rocking chair deep dive. Can you share an updated screenshot now that the rocking chair is further along? Beth, I would love to. I hope everyone has been enjoying seeing the progress on this object so far. Here it is a little further along. This program also allows us to set the rules for the object materials, footprint size, and rig it should use, as well as all the color variants and swatch colors you see in the catalog. So this is what it looks like. And it's so cute. It's so low to the ground, and that's what I wanted, because the rocking chairs in The Sims 3, or at least the ones I think that came with Supernatural, they seemed a little higher up, and I wasn't like the biggest fan of them, but I love these. They're very homey, very cozy, very low to the ground. Thanks, Beth. By the way, Beth is on Twitter at SimGuruBeth, so be sure to follow her, and thanks to all of you Simmers for following this pack's development. This has been a really fun project in a very crazy time. A big thank you to all my Stuff Pack teammates, and especially SimGuru Sarah, who edited my insane rambling and wrangled the miscellaneous bits for these posts. While this concludes my design deep dives, we still have more forum posts and development insight on the way. Keep checking the community Stuff Pack forums, and we'll have more fun stuff to show off in the weeks to come. Until next time, Sim Guru Connor. Whew, guys, that was amazing. I'm excited. I'm also out of breath. I need water so bad. Tell me what you think so far of this Stuff Pack, even though it's not out. What are your thoughts on the brand new information revealed in today's video? I'm most excited for the little onesies for the babies, not toddlers, but onesies. Yes, I know we could do it for toddlers as well, but I'm the most excited for the baby ones. I can't wait to see them in these. Oh, they look adorable. I love you guys so much. I hope you enjoyed this video. Share your thoughts down in the comment section below of this pack so far. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a huge thumbs up and add it to your favorites playlist right here on YouTube. Subscribe to become a supporter and ding the bell next to it to receive notifications for any type of future upload on the channel so that you can be a part of the notification squad. You can follow me on social media. That includes Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitch, and more. There's also a link to my merch store, Amazon wish list, all down in the comment section below. It's now compressed to one link, guys, so it's going to be easy and convenient for you. Love you guys, and I'll see you all next time. So long.